Hey everyone, welcome back to Fly with Shubham, and today we'll be talking about course reversal. So what is a course reversal? In easy words, it's basically a U-turn. Or in the words of aviation, it's basically a maneuver required which puts the aircraft on the final approach segment of the flight. Now there are three different procedures that we can follow to perform a course reversal. The first is the 45-180 procedure turn, the second is the 80-260 procedure turn, and the third is the 30-210 base turn, which is also known as the teardrop turn. In this video, we will only talk about the 45-180 procedure turn, which is the most common procedure turn used in the world of aviation. Before we go forward, it is important that we note the CAT approach speeds and the turn timings. CAT A is 90 knots or less. CAT B is 91 knots to 120 knots. CAT C is 121 knots to 140 knots. CAT D is 141 to 165 knots. And CAT E is military operations 165 knots or greater. The CAT A and CAT B timings are 1 minute if timer is started from the start of the turn, or 45 seconds if the timer is started after the completion of the turn. And CAT C, D and E, the timing will be 1 minute and 15 seconds from the start of the turn, or 1 minute after the completion of the turn. Now this information will come in handy when we discuss the 45-180 turn in detail. Now this is what a procedure turn looks like on an approach plate. For better understanding of the procedure turn, let's take a look at this diagram. Let's say point X on this diagram is our reference, and we are going outbound on the leg of alpha, which is shown in red. According to the approach plates of the particular aerodrome, the procedure turn will be towards the right or the left. In this case, we're taking a right-hand example where we will do a 45-degree heading change towards the right, and that is shown by the point Bravo. Now from the alpha leg, we turn right onto the Bravo leg, and after a particular time, we will turn 180 degrees opposite and intercept the Charlie leg, which will be the final approach segment towards the aerodrome. Now when we're about to approach Charlie, the HSI needle on the Garmin 1000 system will move, and we will intercept the final approach segment. Seems pretty easy, right? But all of this procedure is governed by a lot of factors. Most importantly, time, speed and altitude. Now there are some checks which you need to perform in this entire procedure at certain times. First are the hat checks and the 5T checks. It is important to know that every operator or flying school might have a different procedure or checks according to their standard operating procedures. Now the hat checks are generally performed 2 nautical miles before the turning point. Let's say you need to perform a procedure turn at 5 nautical miles, so you will do the hat checks at 3 nautical miles. The H will be the heading, which we will calculate with a 45 degree change. Let's say you are on a heading of 245. So the heading that you calculate according to the hat checks will be 290, which will be a 45 degree heading change towards the right, or 200 if the procedure turn is towards the left. The A is the altitude which you will maintain as per the procedure charts, and the T is the timer which you will put on standby. This can be followed by the 5T checks. The first T will be the twist, where you will change your course to the inbound course. The next T can be timer or turn, depending on your procedure. Let's take a look at the procedure turn. The first step would be to conduct the hat checks 2 nautical miles before the turning point. According to the charts, the turning point can be towards the right or the left. So a plus minus 45 degree heading change will be taken from the current heading which you are flying on. So let's say you are flying outbound on a heading of 245 and you want to do a procedure turn towards the right hand side at 5 nautical miles. So at 3 nautical miles you will conduct the hat checks, and the new heading will be 290, which will be a 45 degree addition to the heading of 245. The altitude you will maintain, and the timer will be on standby, followed by the 5T checks. So the inbound course for the 245 heading will be 065, which is minus 200 plus 20. Now the second step would be to maintain 45 seconds on the new heading 290, plus minus winds depending on whether it's a tailwind or a headwind. Or it'll be 1 minute if the timer is started before the turn, plus minus winds. So let's say you're experiencing a 4 knots tailwind at the new heading 290, so you will subtract 4 seconds from the 45 seconds or the 1 minute depending on when you started the timer. Or if you're getting a 6 knots headwind, then you will increase the timer by 6 seconds. Meantime, on the heading of 290, your next step would be to turn 180 inbound. So before turning, you need to calculate your heading and you need to conduct the hat and the 5T checks again. There is a formula which will help you calculate the new heading easily if it is a 180 opposite. That is plus 200 minus 20 or minus 200 plus 20 depending on your current heading. Let's say the current heading is 290. So what the 180 opposite of that will be 290 minus 200, which is 090 plus 20, which is 110. So the new heading will be 110 after a 180 degree opposite turn has been taken. And you will follow the new heading till the HSI needle moves. When the HSI needle starts to move, you intercept the inbound course, which will be 065. Let's take the same example in a diagram form. Over here we can see the 180 radial, over here we can see the 270 radial, and we are outbound on an approximate heading of 245. According to the hat checks and the 5T checks, let's say we are taking a procedure turn at 5 miles towards the right hand side. So from current heading 245, we will add 45 and get our new heading as 290. Over here, as you can see on Bravo, we'll follow the heading 290 when we turn after we are done with our hat and 5T checks. One of the most important factors to note at this particular point is whether we start our timer before we start our turn or we start our timer after we have completed our turn. That will decide what time we will fly on the particular leg on Bravo. Depending on the approach speed of your aircraft, the CAT category will decide what timing will you fly on the leg of Bravo. The approach speed for a Cessna 172 is 70 knots. We need to know what time we will be flying on the new heading of 290. So there'll be 45 seconds if the timer is started after we've completed the turn, plus minus the winds. Let's say we're getting 6 knots of tailwinds after we've completed our turn onto the new heading 290. The tailwinds will allow our aircraft to move faster, so we will subtract it from the 45 seconds timer that we have started. 45 minus 6, which will be 39. So we will fly on the leg of Bravo for 39 seconds. And then we will turn 180 degrees opposite to intercept our new heading. Now while you're flying on the leg of Bravo on the new heading 290 which you've calculated, you need to calculate your 180 opposite heading as well, which will be plus 200 minus 20 or minus 200 plus 20. So you're flying on a heading of 290 and you need to make a 180 degree turn towards the left hand side. So it'll be 290 minus 200, which is 090, and 090 plus 20, which is 110. As we have calculated. So this new leg, this particular leg, which you can see will be 110 heading, which you will follow till the time the HSI needle starts to move. And as the HSI needle starts to move, you will get back on the track of Charlie, which will be of heading 065. Now how do you calculate the inbound course for this particular heading? Let's say this heading was 245. So you calculate 245 minus 200, which is 045, and 045 plus 20, which is 065. That'll be the inbound heading that we will follow when we complete this procedure turn. Let's take a look at this approach plate to understand the procedure turn better. In this approach plate, you can see that the procedure turn is towards the right. We are going outbound on a heading of 118 degrees and we turn 45 degrees right to the heading of 163. After following the heading 163 according to the timing, we follow the heading 343, which is the 180 degree opposite of 163, as per this approach plate. When the HSI needle starts to move on the heading of 343, we intercept the heading 298. That's all there is to procedure turns. Some of the few important things to keep in mind are the approach speeds, the turn timings, heading calculations, altitude and timer.